Hey everybody, my name is Ricardo De Cruz, and I represent Joman Auto Service, Complete Auto Reports, and 7-Step ADAS. So today, we are in the 2020 Audi Q3 that you saw me perform a 360 calibration and the forward-facing camera calibration. So the bumper had to be removed from this vehicle, and because of that, the dynamic radar calibration needs to be performed again. So here we are on my favorite spot to do dynamic calibrations, the New Jersey Garden State Parkway. And I'm all set up with Otis. I think my internet connection is stable, and I'm going to run the adjustment. So it gives me the warnings. Don't want to perform fault finding. That wasn't the option I needed. So let us try this again. Guided functions, adjustment. Option one was the correct option. Do not activate any of these functions. And here we go. So the screen tells me I have about 19 minutes left from my experience. The last time, it should be done relatively sooner. And if you're just tuning in, we are in a 2020 Audi Q3 performing a dynamic drive recalibration. The recalibration is being performed because of the front bumper being removed after we fixed the camera. I'm sorry, after we fixed the headlight. So I just got an error message for tire pressure, which is interesting. So I wonder if that's going to affect the calibration at all. That's what made me lose my train of thought. So again, if you're just tuning in, hopefully I'll get this right this time. This is a 2020 Audi Q3. We had previously performed a dynamic drive calibration, but we had to remove the bumper because of some issues with the front right headlight. And since we removed the bumper and we changed the position of the front radar sensor, it should be recalibrated to ensure it is accurate. So we are now on the Garden State Parkway performing a dynamic drive calibration with Otis software and the 2020 Audi Q3. Calibration has completed. So I am actually going to pull over at the rest stop up here, show you what the screen says. You can see the green screen over here. That means that the calibration is done. So green screen, Otis is letting you know the calibration drive is completed, wants you to turn, wants you to turn the engine off and the ignition on. So we're going to do that now. Okay, and we're going to hit continue. Green screen went away. Ignition on. Ignition on. Ignition off. Back on. And there are our results, and we're all set. So I'm going to get back on the parkway for just
couple of minutes to show you how you can quickly test the basics of adaptive cruise. So when you're doing your follow-up videos, because we highly recommend that you test drive each car after an ADAS calibration, most especially after collisions, you should do a short drive to confirm that things are working the way it's intended. So here we're going to turn on our cruise control. We're going to set our speed for New Jersey's 65 mile an hour limit, and our distance is max. So this is a bad spot because a lot of people merge and don't know how to merge, so that could potentially create an accident. So we're going to move over one lane, allow everybody to merge, and here where traffic slows up is where we can see how things are working. So I'm set at the maximum range, and it's holding me at 62. I'm going to set my distance to the minimum. Let's see if the car gets closer in distance to the car in front of me. It should. Each bar typically represents about a car length and a half to two car lengths. So you can see I'm getting closer, and it's closing up the gap. Driving like this kind of prevents people from cutting you off. Doesn't mean that they won't do it. Like you see this guy on the right is trying to. But when you're in stop-and-go situations, the first range of distance is probably the safest for you and passengers around you. When you're on a free-flowing highway, the larger ranges are better because you typically don't need as much time to react. While I'm doing this, I typically confirm blind spot, things of that nature. Depending on where you are, you can try and get close to the lines to confirm that your camera calibrations are accurate if they were performed, or if they're accurate in general. So with this car, I'm going to get close to this left line. It might not even be engaged. So as you can see, cruise control set at 65, closest distance, car is doing 56 and slowing down. I'm going to drop back the distance here to the furthest distance again. You'll see how it'll start to separate and open up space. And this pretty much covers the very basics of adaptive cruise function and what you would look for in operation when you're done with your calibration and you're taking a drive to confirm it works. These are the basic requirements that it should meet. It should make you feel safe, because if it makes you feel safe, it will make the owner of the vehicle feel safe when they get in and drive it again. So I'm going to pull over up here and turn this session off. If you guys tuned in, I greatly appreciate your support. If you have any comments, please feel free to leave them below or reach out when you have time. And other than that, we will catch you on the next one.